This is my dad. He died almost a year ago. He had Alzheimer's disease. He's a lovely guy, isn't he? But this talk is not about him. It's not about how he tried to hold on to life and to normality and how he slowly drifted out to sea. It's not about my mellow dad who turned into an angry man and started bullying me around. It's not about my stubborn dad who wanted to be the director of his own life and lost direction. This talk is about my mother, my brother, my sister, and myself, because the day my father was diagnosed with Alzheimer's, we were diagnosed as well. I vividly remember that day. We were in the hospital, mom, dad, and I, and the room was stark white. And the doctor showed us the brain of my father on the screen, and it had shrinked. It looked like a dried walnut. It was official, Alzheimer's disease. And I asked the doctor, "Now what?" And the doctor said, "Now nothing. Alzheimer is different for everybody. There's no cure and no standard treatment for it. Nobody knows what will happen to any one person. Alzheimer, it can evolve in 2 years, or it can evolve in 20 years. Your father can change quickly or slowly. Alzheimer is an unpredictable disease. It's an elusive disease. The only thing we do know, the doctor said, is that we don't know much. So I asked, will he forget our names? And the doctor said, yeah, I don't know, maybe, maybe not. And I asked, how can we help him? And he said, I don't know, it depends. There is no telling. Then the doctor offered my father the opportunity to participate in some scientific experiment, and he handed over a tray with yogurt drink. Anti-Alzheimer yogurt drink, said the doctor. Maybe this will help. It was a cold, bleak day, and we were standing outside the hospital, puzzled, with a tray of anti-Alzheimer yogurt drinks in our hands, feeling lost. My dad had just been diagnosed with Alzheimer's, and we, his loved ones, had been officially appointed as caregivers, not knowing anything. So this was 7 years ago, and I know so much more. I know today that anti-Alzheimer's yogurt drink doesn't help. I know that you don't have to be lost. And I know that I came to hate the word caregiver. Just listen to it, caregiver. It sounds so soft and sweet, so do good, so humane and friendly, so warm and fuzzy. But I can tell you, it is not. It is cruel and it is exhausting. And it wears you out, both physically and mentally. It hurts to say this. We loved our father. Of course we cared for him. That's what you do when you are a wife, a daughter, or a son. But it was hard. One time my mother called me up and she said, "I'm living with a zombie." And I got very angry with her because you don't call my father a zombie. But she was right. It was hard. It was hard for my mother when Dad started following her around the house all the time, day and night, night and day. It was hard for my brother when my father forgot his name. It was hard for my sister when my father said, "I don't need your help. There's nothing wrong with me." And it was hard when I had to take my own father to the bathroom, pulling down his pants trying to make him pee. We cared for my father the best we could, out of love. But it didn't feel like caregiving. At times, it felt like forced labor. When I was young, I used to be a Boy Scout. And you know how it goes when you go to camp. Orientation is part of the big adventure. So you have to find your own way back, being dropped in the middle of the woods, in the middle of the night, with just a torch and a compass. And I used to love that. But this time, we were dropped in the deep, dark jungle of Alzheimer's. And there was nobody around. We were alone, without a scout leader who could guide us when we, or any leader for that matter, who could guide us and when we were feeling lost or when we panicked, without a map, without a torch, even without a compass. There was no oversight, there was no plan, there was no strategy, there was no way out. We lived by the day, not knowing what would be coming next, not knowing what adventure or danger was lurking behind the next tree or after the next muddy puddle. We just marched on. After our father, who walked in strange directions, we were feeling lost, and off we went, not knowing anything. And of course, there's lots of information on Alzheimer's. There are Alzheimer books, Alzheimer documentaries, Alzheimer films, Alzheimer cafes, Alzheimer socks, Alzheimer games, Alzheimer phones that play the tunes of the old days so maybe the patient can remember. There's all that. There are lots of pills. My dad got lots of pills. But what good does it do when you need other tools to survive? When you're surviving in the jungle, you need a torch and a map and a compass. And of course, there are lots of people there out there trying to help. There are psychiatrists. There are family doctors. There are case managers. But none of these people turned out to be the scout leader we were looking for, somebody who could take us by the hand when we were feeling lost or when we panicked. So at one of my talks on my dad, I met this older lady. She came up to me. She was 80 years old. And she looked fragile and dazed. And she told me she hadn't slept for nights. Her husband had Alzheimer's and was spooking around the house, like many patients do. I asked her, "Why don't you seek help?" And she said, "No, I've been married to my husband for over 50 years. We cared for each other, and now I will care for him until the end." So this is what we do. We give, we try to help, but we also survive, we suffer. We get hurt and get exhausted. We are alone, and the strange thing is, we are not alone. Only in the Netherlands, at this very moment, there are 280,000 people suffering from dementia. That number will rise in the near future to over 500,000. Let's do some math. Let's suppose that every patient has 4 caregivers. This means that in the near future, there will be 2 million people in the same situation as we were. 2 million, imagine that. So the biggest city of the Netherlands will be smaller than Alzheimer's City. So we are not alone. And let me take you back to the day my father got his diagnosis. So he was diagnosed as for Alzheimer's disease. Let's go back to the doctor's office. What we really needed was somebody who could help us then at that moment. What you need is somebody who can guide you, somebody who can make a plan for you, a strategy, somebody who can help you make the decisions you have to make, big decisions. So the doctor could have said in this stark white room, listen, I'll draw you a timeline of what is going to happen. And I'll tell you this. We do know that your father is ill. We do know that your father is going to die. We do know that this will take, on average, 8 years. We do know that this will be very tough for all of you. We do know that your father probably cannot stay at home and will have to move to a nursing facility. We do know that you will have to make big decisions on quality of life, on death. But know that I'm here. I'm here to prepare the path in the jungle with you. Prepare yourself. Brace yourself. But you are not alone. We are in this together. My father died almost a year ago. He had Alzheimer's disease. What I do know now is this. My father was ill, he needed care, lots of care. But he was not the only one. So please, take care for the caregivers too. Thank you.